the Paper Bag Princess, and I want to welcome you to my beautiful Beverly Hills boutique. I started my company back in 1995, but the story really started back when I was about 5 years old and my grandmother took me to a penny sale at a church. It's a little rummage sale, and I found a pair of earrings there for 25 cents, and oh my God, to be 5 years old and find a pair of 1950s earrings for 25 cents, well, I was just hooked. The look that I tend to go for, so I've been told, is very feminine, very sophisticated, classic, timeless vintage. And I like to think that when you're wearing a piece of vintage from the Paper Bag Princess, you don't look like you're wearing vintage, because most of the pieces that I select, whether they be from the 20s or right on up to the early 90s, sort of transcend what's happening today in fashion. So it's a very fine line. Most importantly, most ladies like to buy vintage pieces because they can set themselves apart from the crowd and wear something that's really, truly original, or at least the piece that sort of inspired contemporary fashion today. But more importantly, it's all about the quality and craftsmanship that you can find in a vintage piece that you cannot find in the cookie-cutter fashions of today that are made off in China. So it's really all about the quality of construction, the bead work, or the architectural stitch details, that sort of thing. So this is a really iconic piece of Irene, where you can truly see her craftsmanship and her brilliance in tailoring. If you come close and you see just the way she's used the stripes to create this sort of trompe l'oeil in the pocket detail, even the little bound buttonholes, you can see that she's painstakingly made sure that her tailors have lined up these stripes. This is an haute couture piece by a French designer, Carvin, from the 1960s. This is a perfect example how something from the 60s can transcend current fashions of today. And in fact, I used it as an inspiration for the dress that I'm wearing, which is under my own line, Elizabeth Mason Couture. So I've had my business just going on 18 years now, and for the first, say, decade or so, I found that more and more contemporary designers from around the globe were seeking me out to find wonderful design inspiration pieces. So I was working more and more with them, and then all of a sudden I started realizing, goodness, I'm giving these designers all my best ideas when I could in fact be doing this myself. And I realized that was really where I had started in my fashion career, by actually having my own design line back when I was 20 years old. So I started putting a really wonderful team together and using my own archives of vintage pieces to create my own design collection. So I'm very happy to say that 6 years now into it, I've got a really strong collection that the stylists in town tend to call your go-to pieces. And they sort of reflect my collections from the 1940s, 50s, and 60s. This is one of my new designs, and I'm really pleased with it. I call it a gilded cage, and I'm the bird inside the gilded cage.